Hello everyone, welcome to SemiConTalk. Today's topic is TSMC SoIC. Let's talk about it. TSMC SoIC is the technology name coined by TSMC, and it means System on Integrated Chips. It is one of technology of TSMC using fab technology, and fab technology is also called as front-end technology. FE3D means front-end 3D. BE3D means back-end 3D. TSMC SoIC is interconnection technology between chips using fab technology instead of packaging technology, and it looks like this. Packaging technology uses microbump to connect chips, but TSMC SoIC uses copper pad without microbump. In here, you can see microbump between top and bottom chip, and there is gap by these microbump. It uses packaging technology. At the right, there is no microbump and no gap because it uses copper pad to connect top and bottom chip. But what does it mean? Well, this SoIC technology can make much smaller interconnection pitch, means more I/O. Let's check more detail. This is simple comparison for better understanding. From the left, people use solder bump with 150 micrometer bump pitch. It can make 50 I/O per square millimeters. For 100 bump pitch, it is difficult to use solder bump anymore because neighboring solder bumps can touch each other during leap flow process because those are melt. So copper pillar is used because copper does not melt during leap flow process due to its very high melting temperature. And 100 micrometer bump pitch can make 100 I/O per square millimeters. It keeps going. And 20 micrometer bump pitch can make 2500 I/O per square millimeters. How about 10 micrometer pitch? It is difficult to make by copper pillar. That is why it does not use bump anymore. And it can make 10,000 I/O per square millimeters. 10,000. This graph shows relation between bump pitch and bump density. Decreasing bump pitch from flip chip with 100 plus micrometer bump pitch to 2.5D with less than 50 micrometer micro bump pitch. Then SoIC with 10 micrometer bump pitch without bump increased bump density drastically. More bump or bonding density means faster data processing performance. TSMC demonstrated 12 die stack using this SoIC technology, and total thickness was less than 600 micrometers. Let's check its process flow. People believe TSMC SoIC used copper-to-copper hybrid bonding, even though TSMC did not confirm it. So, in order to explain TSMC SoIC process, I will explain about copper-to-copper hybrid bonding process. Step 1. CMP, chemical-mechanical polishing. This process is to prepare final bonding surface. So, wafer surface should be flat without surface defect and should have uniform copper recess, so-called dishing, for example, 5 nanometers. So wafer surface should be flat without surface defect and should have uniform copper recess, so-called dishing, for example, about 5 nanometers. Step 2, surface activation. This process uses plasma, for example, argon plasma, to increase the bonding energy of dielectric material, for example, silicon dioxide. Step 3, chip-to-chip bonding. This process makes bonding of dielectric material, for example, silicon dioxide to silicon dioxide, between top and bottom chip at room temperature. This bonding is covalent bonding, and there is a gap between top copper pad and bottom copper pad. It requires high precision alignment because bond pitch is very narrow, like 10 micrometers, and there is no self-alignment like solder bump. And chip surface should not have any particle, which can make problems to bond chips. But sewn die has debris from wafer sewing, so it is very challenging to remove all particles. Step 4, annealing. This process makes copper-to-copper metal bonding at high temperature, for example, 200 Celsius degrees to 400 Celsius degrees, and it becomes electrical connection. Gap is filled by copper volume expansion by heat from annealing. fill the gap completely without any void is difficult and challenging to solve. In summary, step 1, CMP. Step 2, surface excavation by plasma. Step 3, chip-to-chip bonding for dielectric material bonding at room temperature. Step 4, annealing for copper-to-copper metal bonding at high temperature. Chip-to-chip bonding is made for two areas. One is between dielectric material at room temperature, and the other is between copper pad at high temperature. Key machine suppliers related with this bonding technology are EVZ, SUS MicroTec, ASM Pacific, Besi, and Applied Materials. Copper-to-copper hybrid bonding is used for Sony image sensor, but it is wafer-to-wafer bonding rather than chip-to-chip bonding. Last month, AMD announced a prototype sample, so-called AMD 3D V-Cache, at Computex 2021 in Taiwan. It seems like this product used TSMC SoIC technology. AMD 3D V-Cache connects processor chip at the bottom with L3 cache SRAM memory on top using copper-to-copper hybrid bonding. This technology is developed for gaming, but will be used for high-performance computing in the future. Thanks for watching and have a nice day. Bye-bye.